judge for yourselves what's inside these. Your guess is as good as mine. Bread is baked aboard, and the paymaster has this kind of dough to worry about as well. Besides the baker, the cooks and the soup they prepare in the galley are his concern. And the butchers. Blimey, what's that he's got? His clerical staff keep an eye on the accounts while he samples the food. The clothing store is yet another of his responsibilities. In the main store, they keep everything from an anchor to a paintbrush. And if a fella's got any money he doesn't know what to do with, there's a savings bank. When all that's been attended to, the paymaster commander can call the rest of the day his own. The Polish Premier and Commander-in-Chief honors three British pilots, squadron leaders Forbes, Kent and Kellett, with the Polish equivalent of our VC, the Virtuti Militari. The investiture by General Sikorsky is just a little embarrassing, as the Premier kisses each man in the customary Polish manner. The decorations are for deeds of highest gallantry as leaders of Polish squadrons. In a hangar at an East Anglian fighter station, the King decorates 25 officers and men of the RAF. The Queen is present at the investiture. Wing Commander Beamish receives the DFC, Flight Lieutenant Allard a bar to the DFM and also the DFC, and Flight Sergeant Harden the BEM. Most of these men are already holders of other decorations. How can we on the home front recognize their bravery and back them up better than by redoubling our efforts for home defense?